Welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going through how you install SQL Server, SQL Server Management Studio, and the AdventureWorks DW database. All right, before we do any of that stuff, I want you to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, heck, even turn on alerts so you know every time I post new content. And why not, you know, why not leave a comment down below? It helps feed that machine that really helps, you know, boost my numbers. I'd really appreciate it, okay? Now, you're asking yourself, but Chris, I'm into data, I'm into analytics. Why do I need to learn how to install SQL Server Management Studio and all this stuff, right? The reason we're going to solve this is so you can learn how to write your own queries, start to practice learning how to work with TSQL, because TSQL is one of the foundational languages of data and analytics. It's been around for like 50 years. It's one of the oldest languages out there. No matter where you are, what data you work with, there is need for learning how to work with Transact SQL. And there's no better way to do that than on your own system, querying a database, and, you know, learning how to work with these tools. Installing SQL Server is very easy to do. I'm going to go through all of these things so that you'll see how you download and install everything, how you then open up and start to use these resources, and then how you can, you know, start or installing SQL Server, SQL Server Management Studio, and the AdventureWorks database is very easy. Let's head on down to my laptop and I'll show you how to do it. Okay, so there are links down below for all of these things, but when you come out, I want you to download the developer edition of SQL Server. This will give you all the bells and whistles so that if you like this, you can, you know, you can go deeper and do more with SQL Server. You can, you know, test out all of the stuff that SQL Server has. So first, download the Developer Studio. Then I want you to go out to the second link that is the AdventureWorks sample database. The example that we're going to be using is we're going to be using the AdventureWorks DW 2019. Now, what you basically do is you download a BAK file, is a backup file that you'll use for your to restore the database onto your system. And then you'll be using, you'll download SQL Server Management Studio. This is how you'll start to interact and work with your database. So I've already downloaded these, and so I'm going to run through actually installing them so you can see them one at a time. Now that you've downloaded SQL Server, we're going to click on it and run it. You're going to get this pop-up that says, do you want to run it? You'll say yes. It'll then start to run and install. I want you to do the basic install, right? It's going to run you through some general stuff, blah, 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 except C program files, Microsoft SQL Server. This is that's fine. Install. So now it's going to run through and it's going to give me what my Microsoft SQL Server name is. It's going to be, the server is going to be localhost. I will have a master database that I can connect to. Okay, so this does nothing other than already download from the link I already put down below. So double click on it, click on yes. I'm leaving this open. I'm leaving this guy open because I want to make sure I have my connection string here. I'm going to show you that in just a second. So yes, we're going to install this. All right. All specified components have been installed successfully. That's great. Click on close. Now I can go and I can find my latest items that have been installed. Where's my management studio? SQL Server Management Studio. Now this guy, I like, I'm going to launch this guy. All right. It's going to start to pop up here. It's going to come up. I'm going to go here and it's the server name is localhost. So I'm just going to type that in localhost, right? Connect. And it's going to connect me directly to the server. If you see anything that takes a little while to kick in, you didn't do it right. The next thing we want to do is we want to restore the backup of the AdventureWorks database. Now, this is relatively easy to do. What I always recommend is you start with, you know, connected to your database. You right click on the database and you click on Restore Database. And you're going to then select device, and then click on these little ellipses. And you're going to click on, you know, it's going to be a file-based backup. You're going to click on Add. Now, this is going to, this path is going to take you right where you need to, where the backups are going to be expected to be. So I'm going to copy this value by right-clicking Copy. I'm going to open a folder or browser. I'm going to hit Enter. Continue, so I do get access to this. And then I'm going to take my downloaded copy of the AdventureWorks database that I have right here. I'm just going to drag it right into there. So now I've got the AdventureWorks 2019 database that's going to be available there. Now, it never shows up here, but you can hit refresh. Come on. Go back in. Yeah, go back in. Select it. Click OK. Click OK. And OK again. And now my AdventureWorks DW 2019 database is now available. It's going to be real easy to test this out. I can just expand this, open this up, take a look and see that I've got all of my, you know, general AdventureWorks database tables there. So, all right. So that is the basics of how you install SQL Server, how you install SQL Server Management Studio, and then how you attach the AdventureWorks database to your server so that you can then begin to write and build queries in SQL Server. All right. This is something that a lot of people stumble over when it, you know, it comes to getting up and getting ready with doing data and analytics and learning how to do T-SQL. I want to do this video because I can remember back in the day when I got started, like this wasn't straightforward and I couldn't find a good guide on this. So hopefully this will help you get started and get up and running. Really, this is like the prequel, the install guide of what's coming next in the additional videos that I'm going to be releasing very soon. So thank you guys very much. Again, remember to like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. Heck, even turn on that alarm bell. Really appreciate it. It helps the channel out and it helps me out. So thank you guys very much. You guys have a great day. Peace.